Hey you guys, welcome back to Beam Your Light. Happy New Year, happy 2022, guys. We made it. That is a milestone in the Lord. We are healthy, we are alive, we are in the presence of the Lord, and that is so much to just give him thanks for, you know. Share Thanksgiving today, and just, I'm telling you guys, God is so good. I want to say this before I pray and get right into this word, but just kind of preference, you know, going into the new year, I just felt like us crossing over into this new year was almost like a breakthrough. If you think about it, I don't know if many of you guys can relate to this. Maybe you've experienced this through the Lord, but I felt like a breakthrough in my life. Even coming back to California, because I went to see my family for a few days, and just crossing back, like going back home, I felt a breakthrough, and I felt as though the Lord is doing a new thing. And we hear this all the time, but I really, really feel like God is moving so quickly and suddenly, unexpectedly. God is moving in just miracles. And so I want to share this because when I was on my flight getting to California, I happened to open my window because we were so close to the airport landing. And I just remember opening my window, my visor, and when I looked down, I happened to see the word miracle on top of the roof of a building. And so out of all words, that was just the word that I saw, and God wanted me to see it before we passed it. And so when I looked down, I saw a miracle, and I was like, wow, thank you, Holy Spirit, because you didn't let me miss that for anything. And it was confirmation as to what he's doing in my life in this season. And so that's just a word he's been speaking to me for quite some time. In the last few days, more so even now, he's speaking about miracles and just the transition of his miracles, and like us not missing his miracles. And so I want to pray and then go right into the scripture that he led me to this morning or this afternoon for you guys. And so let's pray. Father God, we just thank you for another day, another year, another minute, another second in you, Father God. We thank you for your grace, Lord, in this hour that is poured out over us, Lord, even though we don't deserve it. We don't deserve anything, Father God. You still call us worthy. You still call us fearfully and wonderfully made in your image. And we just thank you, Father God, that you give us your power, love, and sound mind, that under the sound of my voice, Lord, that you will speak through my lips like clay, that I'm not relying on my own ability, that as I decrease, you increase right now, and that you speak to all of us and confirm yourself to us and give us, pour out your revelation to us in this hour. We pray for your discernment in this hour. We pray for your wisdom in this hour, for your strength and confidence. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Okay, you guys, so I'm going to read in Joel chapter 2, verse 28 is where I'm going to start. So it says, and this is the NIV version, and afterward, I will pour out my spirit on all people. Your sons and daughters will prophesy. Your old men will dream dreams. Your young men will see visions. Even on my servants, both men and women, I will pour out my spirit in those days. I will show wonders in the heavens and on the earth, blood and fire and billows of smoke. The sun will be turned to darkness and the moon to blood before the coming of the great and dreadful day of the Lord. And everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved, for on Mount Zion and in Jerusalem there will be deliverance, even among the survivors whom the Lord calls. Amen. In those days, we're going to move into chapter 3. In those days and at that time, when I restore the fortunes of Judah and Jerusalem, I will gather all nations and bring them down to the valley of Jehoshaphat. There I will put them on trial for what they did to my inheritance, my people Israel, because they scattered my people among the nations and divided up my land. And so I'm going to stop right there. But one thing God was sharing with me in this passage of scripture is his judgment. And we've been hearing this for quite some time, but more so now, the Lord's judgment is falling upon everyone. Everything, right? We see so many things. The minute you turn on the news, there's something going on. There's bad news. There's, you know, the plagues, which is to me COVID. There's a lot of things that are happening, and yet we don't fear because God is with us, you know. And so although this message is a message of heed, but more so of understanding, like put on this wisdom, let the Lord's wisdom just engulf you in understanding that God does deliver us, God does heal us, God does redeem us. Even if we made a mistake or we've taken a step backwards, he puts us right back on track because he loves us that much. He doesn't want us to perish. He says, my people perish for a lack of knowledge. And so when we really submit to God and his word for our lives, we can understand what pleases the Lord, how his heart just his heart's preserved for us. And so when we honor God in all things, God honors us. And so even though this message is about warning and God really pouring out his spirit so that we get it right, is that we walk in his sovereignty, that we walk in his grace and his mercy without abusing it, but instead just acknowledging him and showing him respect, showing him that reverence, because he is God. God doesn't deserve anything from us, but he wants us. He wants our heart. I don't know about you guys, but that's the realest love story ever. And nothing and no one can amount to that, because God is faithful. He's perfect in everything that he does, even in judgment. And so when we go back to reading this, you know, he says, I will pour my spirit on my sons and daughters. He says, your old men will dream dreams. Your young men will see visions. He says, even on my servants, both men and women, I will pour out my spirit in those days. And so I see this very much, so much of what's happening in these days and end times, you guys. A lot of us, you know, God gives us rhema words. He gives us words that are like, on time, and he gives us words that may not sound like, oh, we have to be preaching all the time about the world ending. God wants us to walk in our calling so that we are also pouring out his light, sharing his light, his word, the good news to those around us so that they don't perish. So we have assignments to do while acknowledging God and all that he's doing. So we don't have to fear with God. He gives us the strength and wisdom to understand who he is, to understand his heart, to understand his ways, that we will walk in that and others will see that, wait a second, I have hope. There's hope for me. I thought I was going to perish. I thought there was nothing left of me. I'm speaking hypothetically, but now speaking about myself, generally speaking, personally speaking, I didn't think there was hope for me. I thought what I was going through in my life with my family, like the generational curses, I thought that was my life. I thought that's what was going to be the rest of my life. But God said otherwise. God had other plans. God said, not you, not today. You are chosen. And when God put his hand on me, he has not taken his hand off. And that's exactly what he's doing with many of you guys. I feel the Holy Spirit, you guys. God is not done with you. God is pouring out his spirit over you that you may be a true conqueror in him, that you will be seated in heavenly places with him, that those, your family members, maybe those people that you've been ministering to that don't want to hear the word of God, they will see that manifestation and that glory of the Lord in your life and through your life, because God is our Redeemer. He is faithful. And so in these days, God talks a lot about judgment. That's already been happening. He's judging the wicked. He's judging his good sons and daughters. And the thing is, you will see the fruits of both. You will see the fruits. He says a good tree will bear good fruit and a bad tree will bear bad fruit. And you will see, you will know the fruits. You will taste the fruits. And so I want to encourage you guys with this word, because as we continue to move forward in the Lord, God wants us to not fear. There's no such thing as fear. God wants us to live in abundance with him, that when the opposition comes, the enemy knows who you are in the Lord. You have more power over the enemy. You have more authority over the enemy than he does over you. So when you give in to his tactics, you're letting the enemy come in and mess with you. But when you take the word of God, his truth, his faithfulness, and you apply it into your life, and against every opposition and circumstance, everything must bow down to the Lord. And he talks about, my spirit will be poured out over my sons and daughters in these days. And so I want to read the study note before I end this word, because I know it'll bless you guys. And so it's a study note to verses 30, 31, and 32. I'm going to go ahead and read it. And it says, these wonders would give a hint or a picture of a coming event. The day of the Lord is used here as God's appointed time to judge the nations. Judgment and mercy go hand in hand. Joel had said that if the people repented, the Lord will save them from judgment. In this day of judgment and catastrophe, therefore, some will be saved. God's intention is not to destroy, but to heal and to save. However, we must accept his salvation, or we will certainly perish with the unrepentant. Listen, y'all. The word of the Lord is a lamp to our feet. He's the one that guides us. He's the way, the truth, and the life. And so when we plug into God and in his ways, and we tap into his forgiveness and convictions and repentance and walking in his grace and mercy, God is with us no matter what, you guys. And so he comes in to redeem us, to save us. And we want the salvation of the Lord, that it is a gift. You cannot just obtain it. It is a gift you receive. And God does the rest as you plug into him. So I encourage you guys with this word. I pray that this word bless you guys like it blessed me, and I will talk to you guys soon. Happy New Year. I pray that you guys have a wonderful start to your year, that the Lord's favor and abundance is over every single person watching this. I pray also that your barns will be filled with plenty, that you will be a greater blessing to those around you, and the ministries and callings for what God is calling every single one of us to do, that he is supplying all those things in our favor. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.